Here we go! Boom. 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 Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another go-round where I remember to turn on the ring light that is around my camera. As I take you on a journey with weights in mountains up through Psijic Order right. Six. Today is gonna be a fast day. Well, faster. Because my work is in Shadowfen and Deeshaan today. As I showed you last time we were together. And the Psijic Order has already sent me to work in those zones before. So I have a few way shrines that I can use to my advantage. But first, I'm going to remember the fact that I forgot to look at my skill book. Maybe I have skill points to spend. Maybe I don't. We'll find out soon enough. Once I have entered the world of the Elder Scrolls Online. All of these wavy screens are starting to drive me nuts. There we go. It's in mountains, it's in Shadowfen. Popping out of character for a moment, I managed to clean up the mess of the little one before we started, because I noticed it was there. And my ball did not roll into it, so we should be able to go uninterrupted. Unless one of my family members decides to make lunch and then does this and then serves it. Instant clothing research. View rewards. Sadly, I have missed the 5,000 alliance points. But I'm here to look at my skills, and I have 3 skill points. Apparently, my hunting for points to use has done great good. Ooh, clairvoyance. Alright, accelerate. Bend time and space to gain major expedition for 4 seconds and minor force for 12 seconds, giving me more crit damage by 10% and movement speed by 30%. Let's see here. Imbue weapon, choking talon. This one's great if I want to keep at range. Let's do accelerate. then I'll put momentum on this back bar here. Although my DPS has gone up by quite a bit with the advent of the two-handed weapon. I think it might well be a function of the quality of the weapon I was using. Because the one I had before was a green level 9 weapon. So, it would stand to reason that... it wouldn't do as much damage as a on my level and blue counterpart. Ooh, Private Zavid of Seneschal. These guys are mercs. And they're blocking my path. You know, it's kind of annoying to me when you go to ride past an NPC, but they're standing stiller than a statue, and you cannot move past them. So you just run into an NPC in spite of having a horse.
Reach here somewhere. And something's eating it? I certainly wouldn't recommend that, unless you're really anxious to get sucked through your own belly button.
Alright. I'm guessing we're gonna go to this ruin over here. It's been a while since I've done the Psijic quest. Well, this would be the Shrine of Black Maw. There's some Guar and some Kaguri. Kaguri are kind of a pain. Alright. Aha! Yep, I figured the time breach was around here somewhere. On top of that altar there. Interesting. The auger saw the fire that it was on top of. There we go. Now let's investigate the map again. See, there's one on the other side of Stormhaven. Or Stormhold, sorry. Okay, so it's around the Camp Silken Snare-ish. Or maybe it isn't. We shall see. Apparently I cannot mount in that little dish. That's actually kind of frustrating, as I would like to be able to ride. But not too frustrating, as the problem was solved by me going here. Alright, let's see just what kind of trouble we can get into. This might hurt, or it might not. Actually, it did kind of hurt. It took, like, half of my health. Baskets! There's skeletal warriors here. In a village. There should be a sky shard around here somewhere. It appears that that person is dealing with these guys. Hopefully that sky shard is not up there. It's in the waterfall. Oh, good. I was going to attack the things that were killing me, and then I found that I was attacking mud crabs because they happened to be in the area. Okay. Still Rise Village. Oh, look! There's a chest underneath the tree. With a simple lock. So I have plenty of time to unlock that. And thank you, by the way, to the warden who basically saved my life, casting that healing spell. You really did me a solid there. Oh, wow. It appears that we've got people doing battle in this village. Oh, look, the Cradle of Shadows. While I'm here, I can show you what happens when you go into this little dungeon here. You technically don't have to, but when you go into the dungeon, both of the dungeons that are here, I think, that are part of the Merkmire DLC. The Merkmire DLC, you get an interesting achievement. And the Cradle of Shadows is one of those dungeons. The Lady of Lace. And there's an image of a spider that's sort of a humanoid. Oh, look. Shadows of the Hist Explorer. Take a look at that. Go to collection book. And I can act like a duchess. I can act like an assassin. Or I can act heroic. Cool beans. Do-do-do-do-do. Apparently, I had already wandered into the other dungeon that was needed for this achievement. Rather fortuitous. So that when I spoke of the achievement that you could get, I could actually show it to you. Still Rise Way Shrine, and that is the shadow. Cool Mundus Stone. But I need to go over to Stormhold. And I'll be back in a few seconds. Okay. Now that my business is complete, I'm gonna ride off to the stable master. Hello.
We don't get a lot of calls.
The tree weep.
What nonsense. Everyone knows the hist isn't a tree.
Will we ever feel safe again?
I believe that the next breach is in this general direction. And this is the local public dungeon up here. You can see the emblem. But the breach is more downward. Ah! There we
Dreg,
go.
I'm telling you, mate, they used to be a lot more pleasant. Now these land dregs are all crab-faced and stabby. Shame. Let's find this breach and move on, eh?
Yep, let's do that. Figure out where the hell it is. Sanguine's Demence. Ah, yes. It's a good thing these dreg aren't aggressive. That would make our path here a lot more... slow, I guess? Well, here's the Bog Mother's Way Shrine. We've got more dreg inland. Oh! This ruin is called Bog Mother. There's a tree minder. And now I know where the breach is. It's underneath this tree here. Oh, good. Now I can seal this breach. Two out of nine. Map of Black Marsh, now it's way the fuck down here. I don't have any way shrines that go down there yet. But I do have a Venomous Fen's Way Shrine. Let's look at my quest map again. Down here. Alright, so it'll be faster for me to nip over to the Bog Mother Way Shrine and then grab the Venomous Fens. Still gonna be kind of a dangerous journey after that, though, but it'll probably be worth it. I'm Ebonheart Pact, so when I go a quest in here, which will happen a whole lot faster than anywhere else in other alliances, like the Daggerfall Covenant lands or the Altmeri Dominion lands, I'll have the Way Shrine so I can get around faster. Oh wow. White Rose Prison. Oh come on! The stupid barricades. They're worthless anyway. They don't keep the prisoners in to save their freaking life. Why even bother having them? All it does is slow down the adventurers trying to get there. Holy shit, that dude just teleported. Alright. So you start hitting me, and then you run away. Well, I guess it's better than being killed.
What is it?
Nothing. I want nothing from you. And let's just hope that none of the water is deep enough to dismount me in this general area. Oh, good.
What?
These guys are not aggressive. I'm glad. Oh. Would you look at that? A roadway that leads out.
A visitor? To the prison? How unusual.
Actually, I'm just passing through. And I am going to sell things, or just buy a repair from this merchant. Alright. Sell off that old hide helmet that's just white in quality. And sell off the green helmet that's just white in quality. Let's go take a look at this world boss, the slaver camp. Enslaved hunters and Rendrassa. Well, I do not envy those hunters who got enslaved. Oh good, I can morph critical charge now. Lorcel and its way shrine. Oh, there's a breach out here, too.
His ruins are dripping with old intention, mate. Forgotten dream forms, frothing hour beasts. Great place for a blood ritual. Or a very unsettling birthday party.
Okay. He said that as I walked around the old ruins of Laura. Yeah. You know. Oh, no. Apparently these are the wrong ruins. Hit the K button and morph a skill. Two-handed. Yes, I definitely want to morph critical charge. More damage based on distance. Deal damage in an area around them. Yeah, dealing a dot is probably a good idea after I reach my opponent. Yeah, that's probably where I'm headed. The Child Mosca Ruins. Unsettling birthday party. Now, wouldn't that just be a clue? These guys are lamia. You have the opportunity to meet some in Oblivion. Cold Harbor, to be exact. I wonder just how many times we say the words Oblivion, but then don't think about the fact that there's like a bunch of different places in Oblivion. Probably a lot. Cannot mount in combat. Well, fine, then I'll just run until my skill bar goes away. That's the sign that combat has ended. Hismir. Interesting. And then there's another sky shard over here. Let's see what I can do. This one's a pact guard. So we're dealing with a city. It's an actual city in which I found a sky shard.
A word.
Nope, not gonna take a word. Good luck climbing this rock that I just used my horse to jump over. And that's the Hispear Way Shrine. If you take a boat, you arrive in Stormhold.
You're not here to complain.
But there's another port in Shadowfen. Frankly, I think Shadowfen has a lot of ports in it. And a lot of starboards, too. So I'm about halfway to the other breach. Yeah. Bitter Root Cave. Probably shouldn't eat the roots there, they might well be poisonous. Plants that are poisonous often use that as a defense mechanism against plant eaters. Bitterroot Cave. I'm wagering that there's a major lamia? Yeah, lamia. At the end of that cave. And Wamasus here are always elite monsters, no matter what you do. You can kill them by yourself, but if you don't have to, then, and you're kind of trying to do a time crunch, then, well, I'm about to finally discover the way shrine to the hatching pools. This run is going to be a more focused run. Let's go down some more. Zona Shop Mine. I am literally running on the edge of this pool here. Oh, look. The cave is actually boarded off. Apparently, it got too dangerous. Maybe it used to be a Quama mine? I'm not aware of any Quama mines here in Shadowfen. The Argonians don't really eat Quama. Oh!
Reaching that Argonian settlement, I think. Ah, I love Argonian architecture. Who needs nails and hard angles? Just pile up some slop and call it a house.
Alright. Here, let's discover this way shrine. And then let's head over to the town. The percolating mire. Yay, I discovered the town. Oh, and look, the time breach is so easy to find. Oh, wow. Apparently there's a bunch of Dominion soldiers that took over the area. Okay. Seal this breach. Really? Stupid Dominion cutthroat. Well, I believe that you, sir, have just cut your own throat because you're unaware that people are sealing time breaches. Attempting to kill them is likely to get you killed. But if you kill them, then it takes them that much longer to seal the breach. And, well, an unsealed time breach is no fun. Cause we beings of flesh and bone tend to run off of linear time. Anyone living in the dimension currently called Earth knows that. Come on! Really? You can't get up a stupid rock? Hey, go forward! There. Although, I did find a wonderful book, Spirit of Deidra. I could think of a hymn to sing to that, but then again, well. Yeah, let's head over to Alton Cormond. That way I can actually show you the other place where there could easily be a port. Camp Crystal Abattoir? Now, see, when I run into a tree and I can't get past it, that actually makes sense to me. Trees are, like, solid, and they're not gonna move easily because they're rooted into the ground. People, on the other hand, are not rooted into the ground. They can move. So it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. Oh, wow. A botswan. Where do you go, I wonder? Where do you go?
Best not to swim in the swamp water. Why not take a boat instead?
Oh, that takes you to Skyrim. Oh, that's just cool. It appears that I will be climbing onto that big ship in the middle of town. Because the mast of that ship has a sky shard on it.
The guild has need of you, comrade.
You know, you keep saying that. But I'm pretty sure you guys are bad. As in, like, powerful. And can handle yourselves. So, why you whining? And I don't feel like stealing from that crate, but I do feel like getting this sky shard. Oh, there was a door that would have led me out here. I wonder, will I die if I fall from this height? Almost, but not quite. I remember at one point when I was in Cyrodiil on one of my characters, I was at the way shrine of the area, but since I was using the way shrine to try and jump to one of my houses, and you technically can't jump to a house, wow, that kind of got screwed up. You cannot use a way shrine to jump to one of your houses. You just jump there. You can't actually use that way shrine to travel directly to a house from Cyrodiil. You have to go to another way shrine. And you have to be at one of the two main gates for your alliance to do it. Which means that in Cyrodiil, you may or may not be stuck there, depending on how determined you are to get out of the place you're at. Okay. Don't have anything to stick in that box. So I'm going to go that way to seal the breaches off to the west of the Mournhold map first. Right now, as you no doubt have noticed, I am not finding a whole lot to say. That tends to happen to me a lot. Not having a whole lot to say. Except that I'm very glad to have finished almost half of the breaches in this general area within 35 minutes. That tickles me pink. Because I actually do have to, as usual, watch my time. I am under another time crunch. Mind you, it's not a very crunchy time crunch. It's kind of chewy. There is a usage of the internet that will occur at, was it 3:45? Yeah, I think it's 3:45. That's generally a safe bet that that's what's going to happen. Obsidian Gorge! These guys, the Maulborn, are a group of seriously malcontented Dunmer who don't believe in the Tribunal. They believe, as Magistrix Vox, their patroness, that the Tribunal are a whole bunch of fake motherfuckers. And so they tried to get the judgment of Veloth, or she actually succeeded in getting the judgment of Veloth, in order to kill the tribunal.
Oh,
you're too late. I already came out of it. I am after the Way Shrine. I do believe the town is south enough that... Old Ida's cottage. Now I know this water's too deep for my horse to cross, but that's okay. I don't expect him to carry me on his back while attempting to swim. That would just be kind of inconsiderate, I guess. Muthgnar. All right, we should be getting closer to that location of the breach. Anyway, so the Malborn, they are led by Magistrix Vox, and their beliefs are that the Tribunal are a bunch of fake motherfuckers. That is apparently a very powerful zombie. And I'm going to discover this Way Shrine of the Tower, which I do not need to utilize. I do believe it does, like, health and health regeneration. So it's great for tanky types. And there's another group of people that also feel that way. The Ashlanders have felt that way. But usually they're contented just to live their lives and be left alone by the other people that are Dark Elves and other people who are not Dark Elves. Okay, let's go with that. Pick up the legend book of the ghost snake and pick up whatever's in this backpack. It appears I'm going towards that campfire looking place. If I remember correctly, I also need to do the quest in that area to actually get to the location where the breach is. Ah, Narciss. So yeah, the other group I'm talking about are the Ashlanders. Two groups of people who are Dark Elves, but believe that the Tribunal are fake. They just have two different ways of handling it. The Malborn react very poorly, kind of like an angry 4-year-old who finds out that things like the Tooth Fairy don't exist, or that Santa Claus, or finds out something about Santa Claus doesn't exist. Then if they were really invested in that illusion, then they would definitely react as badly as the Malborn. They wouldn't, like, try and kill, because, well, that's usually not how a 4-year-old thinks. But the level of maturity the Malborn display in their reaction isn't about that level. Whereas the Ashlanders, some of them are aggressive towards, people who are not Ashlanders. But that's probably because they're used to people trying to kill them. Let's talk to Vartis Dareel.
My Nyxhounds are nervous. They smell the orcs in the pass.
Citizens
really? Have been disappearing from the roads near here. I came to investigate and found these intruders. Orcs. They've been a problem in the mountains before, but this band is unusually aggressive and organized.
That sounds like a mess. Want me to check it out?
I can't officially authorize it, but it sure would be useful to know why the orcs are here. I saw an orc studying a letter. Might be orders from somewhere. if you could get hold of a copy.
Sure. That sounds like something I can do. Route the orcs
reach around
from
here
mountain
somewhere.
Pass.
Oh, and by the way, Killerus has no idea what he's doing with that stuff. Ah, well, dragon breaks aren't so bad. I'm joking. They're horrific, mate.
You know, there's a really, really, really bad pun that goes with that.
For Daggerfall!
Alright, so it looks like I've already found trouble. And holy crap, have I found some trouble! Looks like critical charge all the way! Too bad. My stamina has run out. Yep, and so has my life force. I am not surprised by that one bit. Yeah, let's head over to...
Give a girl a hand.
The Oath. Our ironclad Oath. Apparently their chief made an agreement.
I've tied myself.
Well, I came to investigate what the orcs are doing in this pass. As well as go and seal a time breach.
I'm angry. In fact,
I'm
going to scout around.
Grab some Kindle Pitch. I think I can manage that. After buffing myself. I cannot wait until that self-heal shows up in my skill line. Because honestly, I'm kind of dying a lot, and I don't like it. Alright, so there's two Kindle Pitch. Let's see if I can get this Guardian to give me the last piece of Kindle Pitch. Nope. They did not give me the last piece of Kindle Pitch. But you might. Alright. You know, I had really hoped to get the last piece of Kindle Pitch by now. Thankfully, Mr. Auger here is patient, has a long range that he will allow you to be in before he stops you from seeing things that are time breaches. Really?
My head. They cut off. You can see my Kralik.
Wow.
Yes, I am. Kralik
well,
is cunning.
Apparently, they murdered the priests and put their skulls in cauldrons.
Now strike back.
That is some nasty necromancy. Of course, I have a necromancer character. So I'm not exactly adverse to necromancy itself. But doing it like that, hey, you did not react to the fact that I was blocking. Sometimes this is so annoying when it does that. It just doesn't register the fact that you've done something. Use the tree to kindle pitch. Mercy, okay. Dwemer Dungeons, what I know. Kirith wrote that book. Alright, so. Time breach is over here. And there's a cauldron full of skulls.
Thank you for releasing us.
Okay. So the time breach is through this gate. It is through the gate! I'm going to grab me some skulls while I'm at it. All right. Hot cauldron.
We can never repay you.
Actually, I don't mind if you don't repay me. I am quite happy to take out a dude using your skulls to do a necromantic ritual. Hey, I did that thing. Good. Slamming this dude in the face seems to have solved the problem. Okay, well there's Vortog, the necromancer. Really? You idiots had to come after me too? And knock me over. What wonderful, delightful people! Come on, get up! Get up for fuck's sake! Honestly! Sometimes I do get very frustrated. Alright. Ring of a Mother's Sorrow. That's a great caster's ring. Alright. Altar of Anguish. Okay.
Like your skull to that pile, meddler.
Oh, good. I can actually heavy attack this guy. And keep charging at him whenever he runs away. Alright. Right. That's my reminder to stream. And if I bash him enough, he dies. And all you tribunal priests which used to live here are now freed.
We are free. Go in.
Flame staff two-handed. Thank you. Now I can go burn the Southern Supply Shack. Wow, reacting very slowly today. I think it might be a problem with the internet, which I have been having for, like, ages. Actually, I haven't been having it for ages. We've just been having it this morning. Okay. So we've got her around here somewhere. Hey, go! Whoa. It appears that we have got a serious argument going on the TV. Hey, what part of do the thing on button 4 did you miss? Apparently the do part. Wow. You did that thing where you... Oh, good. The New Moon Courier. Where on earth did you come from? Alright. Svanildir, you should be around here, but you're not. You're just outside the gate where I had just left. Thank you for being as clear as mud.
Ah, look at the dancing players. Good.
Yep, they're done.
Those covenant, then here's the finish. When you go for the
battle, right. Orc leader
calls himself Grusnak the Impatient. I guess these orcs consider recklessness a virtue. Can't say I think they're wrong. I hear Grusnak is one tough hawker.
Alright. I shall go kick his buttocks by burning the banners, which will draw him out. This form of race against time, accelerate, is not channeled. And as long as I don't stay in one place, it'll be much easier for me to avoid being killed. That'll be more difficult up here. Hey! Not cool. Not cool when you do that right in between me using my abilities, and what I told you to do was faster than you could do it. Ah! Diana Stifer is now playing. Burn the... But didn't I just burn the top banner? Hey, do it! Wow. Slow, 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 slow. Good lord. Yeah. You gods know what's going on. You've probably seen it before. And not just for me, either. Okay. Will that banner actually manage to burn? Apparently you have to stand there the whole time while you're doing it. So I have to go back up! Nothing's respawned though, which makes this a little easier. Can just use my armor. Oh, you were way down here. And I managed to block you when you were standing behind me. That's funny. Alright. Oh, Grusnak is officially mad. Heavy weapons. Good. Good, 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 good. Now I can buy that skill point. I must blow the horn. I gotta toot my own horn.
Who dares to challenge Grusnak?
Where is Grusnak? Oh, he's right there.
I'll have your head, runt.
Register that I have done something. Oh, this could be bad. Yeah. Hey. Ah, well that was shitty. I told you to revive. Ugh. Appears that I may need range. Deal with this guy. Pop up so that I can do my thing. Signal horn.
Who dares to challenge Grusnak?
Hopefully he's not immune to being rooted.
Head,
what part of root this guy to the fucking ground did you miss? Oh good. Oh, Thank God I have help. He goes a lot down a lot easier with two. There. Now I can talk to Svanil there, just outside the gate. Alright, there's a time breach for me to seal. Finally got to this breach. This breach in Deeshaan is what takes the longest. As you've noticed, I did several quests in the area because, well, they're all here. And one of them, since the breach requires you to go around the wall anyway, takes you right on through. And the other one just happens to be convenient when you don't feel like coming back to this little area. You get the orcs out of the pass! And then you help. Fire.
Sure,
yep.
Stones, you
Kroznak is dead.
These troops heard the horn blowing.
Alright.
Oh,
I'm almost level 17.
What did you discover?
The Oathbound brought these documents. And I have just earned Dark Elf Scouting Boots. I'm so happy. Yay! I have new leather. Oh, they're light. Hide guards. Okay. Hide belt. Let's see it. Oh, that's a linen hat. Well, that's definitely not any better than what I have. Steel Great Sword of Flame. Let's see here. Sithis's Great Sword gives me lots of maximum health, and I have a new level. Ooh, look. Weapon damage. Yeah, let's take that glyph. Commit those points. Alright. Take a look at that. I want to wait until rank 38. Momentum is just a great thing for me to have. Skill, that's the word I'm looking for, is the word skill. Alright, Ardent Flame, I'm at rank 17. I can get Fiery Breath in 3 levels. Inferno is a fireball. Ooh, yeah, that's a good spell. You use that on your magic DPS, too. Dragon Leap! I can almost morph my ultimate there. I was going for Dragon Blood, but I may not need it if I have momentum. Alright, I can almost grab Obsidian Shield, too. Yeah, let's do that. I've got no weapon and armor skills that I need. Let's check out the world skills. Hiding and light fingers I don't need. I don't want to morph Soul Trap. Fighter's Guild, I've got no skills to use. Mage's Guild, I've got plenty of skills, but none of them are germane to me. Psijic Order has Spell Orb. Now, clairvoyance is useful. A spell orb won't do very much for me. Let's look at the map here. I've got this place. And it looks like that place over here, next to Mournhold, is actually the next part of the breaches I need to seal. Oh, someone just destroyed a dolmen. I believe this frontage road is still safe. In any case, it's a great location if you're a werewolf to go rack up some kills. the people along this lake are all Malborn. So the only thing you have to watch out for is that you don't attack the guard that will patrol here. Sometimes. There's a packed guard that'll sometimes patrol this area. From Narsis. Alright, let's take a look at the map. So I need to go on the downspur of this road. Because the downspur of this road takes me to the little upswing that has the breach. I don't know if you can hear my dad's dulcet tones through the wall, but he is yelling at his teammates on World of Tanks. I always think it's kind of funny when he does that. Personally, whenever I play World of Tanks, I don't find it, you know, it's okay. It's not exactly my cup of tea, but I don't hate it either. It's like, you know, okay. Although I've found that yelling at tanks was never really my cup of tea. The War of Two Houses. Apparently, the great houses were all at war at some point. Actually, that doesn't surprise me. The Dark Elves are competitive by nature.
A dwarf hole. What a silly bunch they were. Always whacking sprockets with their little baby hammers, toiling away on their tiny brass xylophones. Good riddance, eh?
Such terrible slaughter.
This guy wants to solve the problem of the zombies in the area. And I'm after solving the problem of time breaches, which is near that sort of dwarvish ruin tower thingy. Okay. Although, what's interesting is that lately I've been yelling more at this game. Yes, I did notice. Although it might be very, very obvious to you. Oh look, a Psijic portal. I can obtain loot here. Oh wow, the Plague Doctor's pauldrons. There should be a merchant here. Or maybe there isn't, and I just didn't notice. Well, oh, there's the time breach. At this location, 33.86 by 57.24, and you can see exactly what it looks like all around here. Oh look, a Durzog just respawned. 1 hour, and I have a breach south of this settlement thingy. A breach that is in the ruins where Veloth is. And a breach down here. Okay. So it looks like the Ghost Snake Valley Way Shrine is the closest. Now, normally, I would have, wandered all over this place, because that's usually what I do when I'm on the hunt for breaches. And not the kind you put on the lower half of your body. But I was under a time crunch last time, too. Last time I was here, I mean. Dire Bramble Patch. So I made a point of only taking... Whoa.
Reach ahead. Say, what is it with you bipeds and waterfalls? A deluge of happy water spirits cast to their doom, smashed to bits on the sullen rocks below? Probably a recipe for romance, mate.
Well, we don't see it that way. We just see the pretty water and the rocks and the mountains, and it all just looks kind of pretty to us. We're blind compared to you. Okay. So we've got that college up there. The Shadastula Way Shrine. There is I don't think there's any call for me to go up there. Except if I decide to complete this zone soon. Which I will eventually do on this character. She is Ebonheart Pact after all. Come on. There we go. The irony. Sometimes the harder chests to unlock are the simple locks. The complexity of the lock has nothing to do with it. Just how long you get to unlock it. Twilight's Embrace. Oh, crap. Oh, well. Three traits. Health, spell crit, spell damage, and healing received. You know, that's a great sorcerer set. Let's take a look at that. That's the look of Shadastula, the college. Which means I'm headed in the right direction for the next breach. I'm headed over here. And then there's the ritual. Oh no, that's the mage. Duri Tular's ritual altar. One nasty dude. Let's discover the mage. That's a good place. If I remember correctly, the mage increases your mana regen. Nope, it increases your maximum mana. And there's the world boss that's being killed by somebody. Ooh, I'm gonna go behind this guy. I cannot actually buff him. Even if you've got a world boss on your hands that cannot be rooted, it is worth your time to use choking talons on them, because then they still get damaged. I have decided to derp around by helping to kill this world boss. I do not know if Benzum actually needs the help or not. But I'm figuring that he might appreciate it. All right. I'm so glad he has all the aggro, because honestly, it would suck for me to die. Ooh. He's getting in trouble, though. I believe he's wailing on this guy to increase his skills. It wouldn't surprise me if it were. That seems like something I would do if I had the survivability to withstand such a thing. Okay, you cannot bash him from range. Alright, let's do a few heavy attacks. I do believe that the inner light skill or the revealing flare skill would be dead useful to him. He's almost dead. 3, 2, 1%. And I do believe he is the heavy hitter in this group. The pseudo group. Oh, wow. Plague Doctors. Dremora Dread. I'm gonna read this scroll here. Ooh. Power. Beyond estimation. Okay.
There's a breach here somewhere. Plenty of ilk ghosts, too. Ugh. They won't stop shrieking about... It's either dying or pieing. Pieing's a word, right? To pie? Odd thing to get upset about.
I know, right? Actually, they're pretty mad because they died. Take a look at this. Axe, one-handed, retin, unique, equipped. Bind on equip. So, looks like I have plenty of crap to put in the bank when I find the bank again. Hey, use the auger. Wake up your sight, little one. Little blind one, wake up your sight. Yeah, there's no sneaking past these clefts. Except maybe there is. Hey, I told you to use the potion, you idiot. Oh good, there's a time breach in the middle of the sand. Maybe my potion abilities will come up fast enough and I'll be able to actually... I don't think that Kyngold is gonna leash. Nope, he did leash. Lucky for me. I managed not to draw that clan fear. Alright, 8 out of 9 breaches sealed, and I definitely need to get my health back. Really? You say I'm still in combat even though I didn't? Oh, that clan fear did decide to attack me. He just took, like, a long, long time. Okay, well that was a few seconds of not being hunted. And there's an access to a way shrine. Idilon's Hollow Way Shrine. And there's a merchant! Hello, person who buys crap! No, justice and profit don't know sleep. And frankly, neither do I. Gonna sell off these cheese fries. 8 Scrolls of the Dwemer. And then this book. Alright! Hey, go up. Dragon power. Yes, I can morph dragon leap. Okay. Deals flame damage, and after leaping, you gain a damage shield. Yeah, take flight is a better idea because I'm doing, like, stamina DPS. But first, let's take a look at... One, let's eat the ginkgo lightning. Two, let's take a look at the map. It's down here. Down here. Past the silent mire. Okay. Taldaic grounds way shrine. I noticed that I have a habit of saying things wrong. All right. There we go. Hey, there we go. Oh, look. The sky shard that's over here. Only I don't feel like actually getting it right now. I will, however, go to the Silent Mire and grab the Way Shrine that it has. Maybe I'll do that over here, where the wasps are not. It looks like the breach is going to be by the dolmen. Or maybe it'll be by the dungeon. We shall see. And then, you will have accompanied me through rank 6 of the Psijic Order quest. I commend you for your stubbornness. And resolve to actually get this done. Oh, cool! Destroy the anchor pinion. What part of destroy the anchor pinion did you miss? Oh, there's a person approaching. You can grab that other anchor pinion.
You are
it appears that you've gotten three
with you.
Of them. It appears that my ultimate now only costs 100. Dread Watcher! Ooh, look, let's root all these zombies. That should make it easier for you.
No tales are told of your battle.
Oh, you've said that before, but it never works. Yay, I've completed a dolmen. Definitely not single-handedly. Oh, wow, I can morph imbue weapon now. I guess there's a good reason for me to go hunt in a sky shards. First, let's try going this way to see if I can find the breach. Renjira Pyromage. Ooh, this could get ugly. Okay. Let's see if this place is... having a time breach. Smuggler's Slip. Right, let's take a look at the map again, and know that it's down here. The architecture down there is closer to the dungeon, and the Silent Mire Way Shrine is worth the pennies. I don't have to run past the smugglers again. Though I might run into other big bad nasties. Caravan crest.
Rocks, water, more rocks.
Wait, that's it. Breach nearby, mate. Sorry, just got distracted by all the behemoth mine snails. It's too bad you can't see them. They're really cute. Sort of.
Note to Celius. Hey, you Who's the auger? Wake up. Wake up your sight, little one. You are blinded. Wake up your sight. Step 1, time breach. Step 2, discover that dungeon. Step 3, sky shard. Boom, boom, boom. And then I can morph my imbue weapon. Jelsaja, I have another tale of I did not fail. Let's see what this place is. Dark Shade Caverns. Interesting. You know, this is probably a dungeon that I can do. It's part of the vanilla. Multiple dungeons. And oh, wow. So apparently the Dark Shade Caverns create gourmet guama eggs. Guama! Sweet guama! Okay. Tarvor Sadri is the person who offers you a quest to collect eggs, most likely. Dark Shade Caverns looks like it's gone kind of feral. Maybe that's why it's prized? That the feral eggs are so tasty? I have discovered the dungeon. I'm going to extract the runestone and get a lot of loot for it. My Brigash burial circle. And then there's a sky shard up here with a chest. Wonderful. 2 out of 3 pieces collected. Of the loot hunter hunting for sport, the chest, which is locked. Steel great sword of flame. Alright, I'm going to discover the burial circle of Mabrigash. Holy shit, she's almost dead. Hey. Damn it. I didn't get enough damage in. She died before I could do anything. Oh well. Wow. Sounds like Dad had a very bad time with this game today. And it looks like I am going to find that third skill point I want. Oh, crap. Ooh, chest. Simple lock. It's amazing I find. You know, once you open a chest, it will never spawn in that exact location for you. But if someone else comes along behind you, that chest may actually spawn for them, even after you have opened it. Not immediately after, probably, but still after. I imagine most of the chests are at the simple skill level. And then there are fewer chests. Yes, I did it! It always gives me such joy when I manage to open a chest on the first try. Alright. white cap, crawlers, and alchemical resin. Into this water I go to take a sky shard in a box. I wonder, did they put it there, or did the sky shard land there? Sky shards look kind of heavy. Skill! Psijic Order. And morph imbue weapon. Elemental weapon converts into mana. Ah yes, crushing weapon. Heals me for a percentage of the damage done. Now I have a self-healing on my front bar. Mend Wounds also allows me to heal myself. If you use that, then you chuck balls of healing at your allies when you use it. Alright, so I've got everything morphed on my front bar. Now I just need to skill up my back bar. My two-handed weapons bar. So I'm gonna nip over to Josaja, talk to her, finish the quest, within an hour and a half, no less, and... I love that the sorcerer named themselves Spellcheck. That is such a great name.
Before I was a member of the...
Perfectly frank. I buy and sell all the time. Ugh. My head itches like usual. It's off to Jusaja I go to talk about the next show. And then to the workplace I go. The darkness in time I will throw.
Welcome back, Initiate.
All right.
No shortage of mud on your feet. Looks like we'll have to stop. The staff, after all. I'm sure I don't need to tell you how exciting that is.
You think you'll find a way to keep the pieces apart?
The leadership seems confident enough. As for me, I'm just happy to have the opportunity to see it. Now, you should probably check in with the lore master. With any luck, our scryers have found the remaining fragments already.
Okay. It sounds like Calaris has my reward tonight. And my next quest. He is past the right master's study.
Staff of Towers.
So you're ready for me to go, huh?
But first, we should take a moment to acknowledge your achievement. A Psijic must never sacrifice the present at the cost of an uncertain future. Take this as a reward, Caraval. I suspect you will find a use for it before long.
Oh, I suspect so, too.
We must gather the final fragments of the Staff of Towers.
Okay, where do I find it?
Scryer's visions. Fragments lay buried near the Brothers of Strife and Stonefalls, the Weeping Giant in Stormhaven, Greenheart and Greenshane, and the Spell Scar in Craglaw. There's one other thing I... wanted to discuss with you, Initiate. It will just take a moment.
What's
Once
on
you
your
recover
mind?
These remaining fragments, I would like you to bring them to me directly. I know that you and Josaja have grown more familiar, but allowing her to inspect these artifacts without supervision would be most unwise.
So you think she's gonna try and use it to fix her family
you
problems,
misunderstand.
Huh?
I trust Josaja implicitly. But avoiding temptation is one of the chief pillars of moral action. Her interest in this artifact and its potential applications is not purely academic. I sent
And for the gift. All right, let's replace the arm cops. Yes, I want to bind them to my account. I want to observe that the spell and weapon critical will go down, but the maximum stamina and resistances will go up. I think that's probably a good idea, as they have a good stat set bonus. Oh, and I do in fact get the set. All right. Wow. I got a green one and a blue one. Okay. So it looks like my best bet... yeah. I got a little turned around here. Let's pull up the quest log. Yes, the tower's remains. Near the Brothers of Strife is one of them. Okay, so it looks like the Davin's Watch Way Shrine and pay fewer gold coins to get to Davin's Watch. Near the Brothers of Strife. Then I can literally port myself to the Brothers of Strife. It has its own way shrine, you know. I have almost everything morphed on my second bar. I don't have accelerate morphed yet. And I have, and you probably can't see it, but I'm rushing this because I'm also doing the potty dance. It will not be long until my stream for the day is complete. First, I need to drop a whole bunch of crap off at the bank. Come on, loading screen, load quickly. Thank you. Find the tear near the Weeping Giant below. It wants me to go to the docks in the city so that I can actually go to the Weeping Giant. mediums. I need medium armor. I don't want to take that. I will eventually take the Darlock Bray set. And the guards. Grips of the Impasto. Ooh, the Living Shadow skin. I can almost wear that. Then after that, let's... Let's draw. Nah, let's not draw that. Oh, cool. 84 gold to recall to the Brothers of Strife directly. Now I have all the tools I need and I'm in the right location. Okay, thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Have a wonderful evening. All right. OBS. Stop the stream. Yes, I want you to stop the stream. Don't ask me stupid questions. Now everything.